हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ लेक्चर इज ब्रोंकियल एस्थमा। फर्स्ट वी विल सी द डेफिनेशन। एस्थमा इज ए क्रॉनिक इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिसऑर्डर ऑफ द एयरवेज विच कॉजेज एयरवे हाइपर रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस, म्यूकोसल एडिमा एंड म्यूकस प्रोडक्शन विच लीड्स टू द एपिसोड ऑफ वीजिंग, ब्रेथलेसनेस, चेस्ट टाइटनेस एंड कफिंग। देयर इज हाइपर एक्टिविटी टू वेरियस स्टिमुलाई इन द एयरवेज। लेट अस सी द ट्रिगरिंग फैक्टर्स ऑफ एस्थमा। फर्स्ट इज एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर्स लाइक डस्ट, स्मोक, परफ्यूम्स, then the sudden weather changes, cold climate can aggravate asthma, exhaust fumes from the automobile, pollen grains, then smoke from the fireplace. Next, physiological factors like gastrointestinal reflux disease, some hormonal change, episodes of acute stress, viral upper respiratory infection. Then some medications can also trigger asthma, like aspirin, beta adrenergic blocker, NSAIDs. Next, occupational exposure factors like metal salt, wood and vegetable dusts, industrial chemicals and plastics. After that, there are certain food additives which can also trigger asthma, like sulfite, shrimp, processed potatoes, monosodium, glutamate, etc. Now let us see the pathophysiology of asthma. Any type of risk factors, predisposing factors, or the persons who are prone for getting asthma, or if there is a family history of asthma, that triggering factor will initiate a triggering factor like a cold weather, some dusts, some type of air pollution, any medications. In that case, what happens is that person will have IgE, mast cell mediated response. That mast cell, what it is doing, this will generate an inflammatory response in the airways. Inflammatory response is abnormal. This inflammatory response release some of the chemicals or chemical mediators which causes further changes in the bronchi or the airways of a patient. These chemicals are like histamine, bradykinin, prostaglandin, leukotrienes, etc. This will cause bronchoconstriction, excess of mucus production, and so the airway will get narrowed and the person will have symptoms. The mast cells, neutrophil, eosinophils, lymphocytes play a key role in the inflammation or asthmatic attack. Mast cells are releasing several chemicals which I have already said. They will aggravate the inflammatory response, causing increased blood flow, vasoconstriction, which I have already said, vasoconstriction and also bronchoconstriction, fluid leak from the vasculature, attraction of WBC to the area, and bronchoconstriction. The signs and symptoms of asthma are cough, wheezing, dyspnea. This is the main classical sign and symptom of asthma. Then feeling of chest tightness, prolonged and forced expiration. Initially, the person will have wheezing sound on expiration. And if that asthma is not द पर्सन डज नॉट रिकवर और द एस्थमा गेट्स वर्सन्स, देन ऑन इंस्पिरेशन ऑल्सो द पर्सन विल हैव वीजिंग साउंड. एज द एक्सकर्वेशन प्रोग्रेसेस और वर्सन्स, द डायफोरोसिस, टैकिकार्डिया, वाइडेंट पल्स प्रेशर, हाइपोक्सीमिया ऑकर्स, सेंट्रल साइनोसिस ऑकर्स. हाउ टू डू द असेसमेंट एंड डायग्नोसिस? वी हैव टू टेक द पेशेंट हिस्ट्री, देन एनी फैमिली हिस्ट्री, एनवायरमेंटल हिस्ट्री, व्हाट आर द ट्रिगरिंग फैक्टर्स, व्हाट आर द डाइटरी फैक्टर्स, एनी एक्सपोजर टू द environmental pollutants, etc. We have to take a detailed history to find out how the asthma is aggravated or when the person gets an attack of asthma. Then physical examination. On physical examination, wheezing sound is heard. Then the person can have shortness of breath. Then tachypnea is also seen on physical examination. Then spirometry or pulmonary function test, in that forced expiratory volume will be reduced at the time of attacks and it is completely reversible. That means FEV1 will be normal when the person takes the drug or when the symptoms improves. Then sputum and blood test can also be done. In acute episode, elevated level of eosinophils can be seen in the sputum as well as in the blood because it is a type of allergic reaction. Then ABG analysis to find out hypoxemia during acute attack. Skin test can be done to find out the allergens which is causing asthma. The management of the patient with asthma is as follows. First, use of drugs. In that, the drugs are classified into short-acting or quick-relief medications and long-term maintenance drugs. In quick-relief, examples are given like inhaled beta-2 agonist, albuterol, levobuterol, perbuterol, anticholinergic to reduce the secretions or mucus production, ipratropium, then corticosteroid will decrease the inflammatory process. These are methylprednisolone and prednisolone. Long-term control medication include steroids. First line is steroid. Inhaled corticosteroid, examples are beclomethasone, budesonide, then systemic corticosteroid can also be given in the form of tablets like methylprednisolone and prednisolone. Then long-acting beta agonist. It is a type of bronchodilator. Example of long-acting beta-2 agonist is salmeterol, used with inhaled corticosteroid. Then cromolyn can also be used for the mast cell stabilizer so that mast cells are not activated. Then methylxanthine, it is also a type of bronchodilator which can be used. Let us see the nursing management. In that, we have to first do the assessment to find out the cause of asthma, to find out the condition, present general condition, so that a baseline data can be gathered and accordingly management of the patient is done. In that, we have to review the patient record, assess vital signs, auscultate the chest for breath sound, assess the rate and depth of respiration, observe inhalation techniques. We have to see whether the patient has been relieved from the dyspneic attack by monitoring the vital sign, skin color, any type of retraction, degree of restlessness is reduced or not. We have to provide oxygen therapy to reduce dyspnea as well as to maintain oxygen, partial pressure of oxygen, monitor the airway functioning, encourage intake of liquids to liquefy the secretions. Encourage patient to use adaptive breathing technique to decrease the work of breathing. Chest physiotherapy, postural drainage helps to mobilize secretion, relieve the anxiety of the patient, which will prevent further attack. Encourage active participation and support efforts to adhere to the management plan. Provide information on the nature of asthma and method of treatment. Provide information regarding medications. Demonstrate the patient how to use MDI, metered dose inhaler. Then we have to teach the patient about adaptive breathing techniques. Then ask the patient how to avoid the environmental triggering factors, like avoid people with respiratory infection, avoid substances and situations known to precipitate bronchospasm such as allergens, wear a mask if cold weather precipitate bronchospasm, stay inside when the air pollution is high, promote optimal health practices including nutrition, rest and exercise. This is all about the topic. You can refer from any textbook for further details, and if you have any questions, you can ask. Thank you.